Good morning, children. I hope that you are all well and fine. And one more thing where we have to remember is that stay home, stay safe. Right. Coming up to a regular class, now we are entering to the 16th lesson. That is National Movement in India and Partition and Independence during 1939 to 1947. Means what are the changes it has been taken place in India during 1939 to 1947. Many changes has been taken place in that. One is we got independence on 15th August 1947. That is one big change. Then division of India into two parts. That is India and Pakistan, like that many changes have been taking place. So before that, mega events, mega changes, big changes have been taking place. That is, one is Quit India Movement. Quit India Movement has been started in the year 1942 on 8th October it was being started by All India National Congress. So, 1948 August, Quit India Movement has been started by INC. INC means Indian National Congress Leaders has been started. In that, the main person is Mr. M.K. Gandhi. M.K. Gandhi means Mohandas Karamchand. Gandhi is the main person who has started this Quit India Movement. So, later on the next day, so on 8th August 1942, they started the Quit India Movement. The next day itself, all the leaders of the Indian National Congress has been arrested by the Britishers. This Quit India Movement is mainly to quit the Britishers from India. Means Britishers are dominating on all Indians and dividing the people on the name of religion, on the name of caste, and ruling on us. So not to happen that the main person for the Quit India Movement is Mr. M.K. Gandhi. That is Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi. We have started this revolution, Quit India Movement, on 8th August 1942. So the next day itself, all the leaders of the Indian National Congress has been arrested by the Britishers. By the middle of 1942, Japanese troops were approaching us. So during that period only, in the year 1942, and even we remember in the year 1939, one biggest event, tragedy, has been then in India, not in India, in the world, that is Second World War. World War II has been started in the year 1937-39 and ended in the year 1945. So almost 6 years. So during that, during the Quit India Movement, the Britishers was in the allied power, and Germany, Japan, Italy and other countries were in the Axis power. At that time, the Britishers, India was the colony of British, and Britishers is seeking the permission of Indian political leaders to send army to the to fight against the Axis power, that is against the Germany and Japan. Then in March 1942, the Prime Minister dispatched Sir Stafford Phipps, a member of War Cabinet, to India to discuss the British government's draft declaration. So in the year 1942, in the month of March, the Prime Minister of British has sent one person, that is Governor General, you can say, his name is Sir Stafford Phipps, a member of War Cabinet, to India to discuss the British government draft declaration. The draft was the Act of 1935. The draft was unacceptable to the Congress Working Committee, who rejected it. The failure of Phipps' mission further estranged the Congress and the British government. From 29th April to 1st May, all the Indian Congress Committee assembled in Allahabad to discuss the resolution of Working Committee although Gandhi, yes. Yes. On 7th to 8th August 1942, all the Indian Congress Committee members in Bombay and ratified the Quit India Resolution. Gandhi called Do or Die. Do or Die. So, the Quit India movement. More than anything, united the Indian people against the British. So during this Quit India movement, it hasn't got much success. But it has united the people. Means all the people of India has been united in the Quit India movement. And they started revolting against the Britishers. Although most demonstrations have been suppressed by 1944 upon his release in 1944, Gandhi continued his resistance and went on a 21-day fast by the end of Second World War. Yes. So, in spite of Quit India movement and many other movements have been taken place, in the 1944, Gandhi, after releasing from the jail, he has gone for a hunger strike. He has started fasting without taking food and water for 21 days after the end of Second World War. So who are the leaders who joined in the Quit India movement? Means many leaders were there in the Quit India movement. Like, the organizer of the Quit India movement is Mr. Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi, and the other leaders are Maulana Abul Kalam Azad, Subhash Chandra Bose, Muhammad Ali Jinnah, Ashoka Mehta, Jay Prakash Narayan, Jawaharlal Nehru, Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel, Dr. Rajendra Prasad, Chakravarti Rajagopalachari, and many other leaders participated in the Quit India movement. Right. Next, about the Muslim League. So, Muslim League means here many parties has been formed during 1906 to 1947. During this period, during 1906 to 1947, many parties were formed. So among them, one party is Muslim League. The partition of Bengal created a communal divide on December 30, 1906. So Bengal was divided into two parts. One is North Bengal and the other is South Bengal, like that. Created communal divide on December 30, 1906. So Muslim League was formed under the leadership of Aga Khan. This Muslim League was formed under the leadership of Aga Khan. He was the Dhaka Nawab, and another person was there who started Muslim League. He is Mr. Nawab Mohsin Ul Mulk, to safeguard the rights of Indian Muslims. The main motto of these two people, Mr. Aga Khan and Mohsin Ul Mulk, the main motto is to safeguard and protect the rights of Muslims. For that purpose, they started the Muslim League. Initially, it got great support from the British. But when it got adopted the notation of self-rule, then they get destitution from the Ambrose session of League held in 1908 under the presidency of Sir Syed Ali Imam, demanding separate electorate for the Muslims. This was conceded by them by his Minto Marley reform in 1909. Yes. So here in 1908, the Muslims demanded to have a separate electorate for the self-government, and this was accepted by Sir Minto Marwar reforms. In Sir Minto Marwar reforms, it was been accepted. And Muhammad Ali Jinnah, Maulana Muhammad Ali, started an English general that is called as Comrade. Means he started one English newspaper. Mr. Muhammad Ali started one English newspaper which called it as Comrade, and Urdu paper Hamdard. He started English paper Comrade, and Urdu paper he started as Hamdard. These are the two papers started by the Muhammad Ali. Muhammad Ali. Yes, British planning to divide Indian on communal lines and adhere a separate attitude in Indian politics. So that was always the policy of Britishers to divide the people on the name of caste, on the name of religion, and get the terrorism from both ends. Here, why this Muslim League has failed me? First of all, there was no education among Muslims. There was no education among Muslims, and they were isolated from Western and technical education. So they were isolated, and they were totally attracted towards the Western and technical education. Technical works they have shown more interest. As we know that 1857 one revolt, that is the 5 minute or first war of independence, that Muslims are dangerous for their colonial policy. Here, economic backwardness of India, lack of industrialization causes acute unemployment, and British attitudes towards the cottage industry was pathetic. So, in India, there was no any industry during that period. And India is not having any technology during that period. At the time, the Indians was totally dependent on the Britishers to overcome from the economic conditions of the society. The main motto of Muslim League is to promote loyalty of Indian Muslims towards the British government. The main motto, the main reason of starting the Muslim League is to get loyalty of Indian Muslims towards the British government, to protect political and other rights of the Indian Muslims. So loyalty, first one is loyalty by the British government. Second is to protect political and other rights of Indian Muslims, and to place their needs and aspirations before the government. Third is to overcome the feelings of hostility among Muslims towards other communities. So these are the main reasons why Muslim League has been formed. So later on, Muslim League fight continuously, and then during independence, on 14th August 1947, India was divided into two parts. One part separately for the Muslim League, that is equivalent as Pakistan, and the other rest of the part is for India. So during division of India and Pakistan, and during migration, many people migrated and many people lost their lives during the partition. Yes, like many other leaders, Subhash Chandra Bose is also one prominent leader who has played a very important role in the India's independence. So during India's independence, many political leaders or many freedom fighters has gone the principle of non-violence. So non-violence, they adopted the principle of non-violence. So similar to that, Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose was also one of the person who fought for India's freedom, but he went for violence. He asked the people of India, "You give blood, I'll give freedom," like that. He asked the people of India, and with the sentiment, many people joined the Subhash Chandra Bose, and he has framed one party, that is, he has framed one army, that is Indian National Army, separately, and fought against the Britishers. during the Second World War, Britishers was in the Allied power, and to get quick independence, he started to fight against the Britishers. For that purpose, he joined Germany. He joined Germany, that is Japan, Germany, and defeated. And most of the British army was killed during this period. During the reign of Chandra Bose, that is Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose. He has gained the title as Netaji. Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose was born on 23rd January. He born on 23rd January 1897. He born. He is one of the most celebrated freedom fighters of India. In 1942, he earned the title Netaji. So Chandra Bose earned the title Netaji in the year 1942. In Germany, by the Indian soldiers of Azad Hind Fauj. So he has formed separate army, that is Azad Hind Fauj. So because of that, he was titled as Netaji. Yes, Bose is Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose is credited with the very famous slogan, "Give me blood, I shall give you freedom," as well as Jai Hind. So the two titles he has given to the people of India, one is Give me blood, I will give freedom. Then another title was Jai Hind. He also credited to the first man to call Mahatma Gandhi father of nation in his address from the Singapore. So he is the first person, Mr. Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose, who has given Gandhiji as the father of nation. Gandhiji as the father of the nation. In 1919, Bose headed to London to give the Indian civil services examination and was selected. Yes. In the year 1919, Bose went to London to give ICS. ICS means Indian Civil Service Examination, and he was selected in that. So after that, however, he resigned from civil services as he believed that he could not side with the British. So he passed that Indian Civil Service Examination, but he resigned that. Why? Because he don't want to become a puppet in the hands of Britishers working for Indians. So in the year 1921, In the year 1943, so many actions are there done by the Bose. In the year 1943, he travelled to Japan and took the leadership of the Indian independence movement in East Asia. With Japanese aid and influence, he took the leadership of trained army of about 40,000 troops in Japan, Japanese. Occupied Southeast Asia known as Indian National Army. The Indian National Army was first formed under Mohan Singh and Japanese Major Iwa Fujiura, and compromised Indian prisoners of war of the British Indian Army captured by Japan and in Malaya. In 1905, the British, he is said to have died in 1945 when his plane was crashed in Taiwan. However, there are still more conspiracy theories regarding his death. So many conspiracy theories are there regarding his death, but he died in the year 1945 in a plane crash.